You blaming her? She not even a part of the court system. Like, this is some regular lady at the 911 job.
Sir, what is going on?
Who the f*** you calling, sir, you stupid
Yo, yeah, this is insane. I ain't gonna hold you. It just goes to show how the property of man, because it should never be this area.
You stupid s***.
Hey! As y'all may know, like, at least a year ago, we looked at some court type joints where people went crazy in the court. And the court is probably where you see the worst of humanity, to be honest, because there's always, like, a loser in there. So we're going to go ahead and look at the three biggest outbursts from thugs in the court. You know what I'm saying? So let's go ahead and get into it.
Now we head to Cleveland, Ohio, to the Cuyahoga County Common Pleas Court for the
Oh, by the way, he did it, by the way. I just want to put that out there. He did it. He did it.
For the sentencing of convicted serial killer Michael Madison. Madison's been convicted on three counts of aggravated murder for the killing and mutilation of three young women in Ohio. Wow. As part of the hearing, Van Terry, the father of one of Madison's victims, steps up to the podium to make a victim impact statement. Mr. Terry's now just a few feet away from the man who so brutally took the life of his daughter, Sherelda.
Right now, I guess
we're supposed to. See, I don't even know how I could be in some of these situations, bro. Like, imagine somebody take away one of your family members and you just gotta see them and you gotta, like, I know a lot of people forgive, but yeah, I'm not gonna lose you. I'm not forgiving. I ain't gonna cap to you. Me personally, I gotta get you, like, we gotta go ahead and talk to some of the booty bandits in jail and get you right. Like, that's just what gotta get done. You feel me? Like, I don't know.
My heart's gonna give this clown.
You mean unban RK? You gonna ban him?
Taking my child.
He's looking directly at Madison.
Ooh. God. That did the Superman that, like, bro, is dead ass serious. I respect it. I respect it. I 100% respect it. He tried it. This out his shoes, I'm pretty sure, Chad. I think his shoes is off at this point in time.
Oh, no!
We gotta go back and see the jump.
He's looking directly at Madison.
Yeah, I respect it. Oh, his shoes didn't come off. No, his shoes did come off. That fell off his shoes. I respect it, man. I 1000% respect it. I respect the energy. I respect the hustle. And I respect the grind, bro.
At Madison.
Look at this. Oh, chat, I'm not gonna lose you. Look at his Mr. Clean looking. Look at, every kiss begins with K. Bro, look at his like, bro. God damn, his head's so shiny. I wish he would have got him, bro. Especially if you smiling at me. There's a red hat on.
Van Terry is released without charges. A short time later,
he better not charge
Judge Nancy McDonald hands down Madison's sentence. Michael Madison is sentenced to death.
I was going to do something crazy, but in fact, there's no point in even doing that. That's kind of.
New op pack in the air, this gas what? He'll still be alive right now if you niggas ain't gas him up.
That's unfortunate. We going to see you, though. We going to see. They got a special place for you.
And will now live on Ohio's death row.
And on Ohio's death row is crazy. That's tough. Like this, right?
Next, we head to the S. James Foxman Justice Center in Daytona Beach, Florida.
We are ready to go for Keandria Cook, Judge.
All right, Ms. Cook, come on up.
The woman being sworn in is 18-year-old Keandria Cook. Cook's in court today to receive a sentence for using a dating app to set up a robbery that ended with another teen being shot.
Yo, you are so lame, bro. You are so lame, bro. Set up, sorry. Anybody who set anybody up is a loser. I'm sorry, bro. And she looked like a GTA 5 extra in the hood. Y'all know them hooded areas, bro. Y'all know this is an extra. You will see a NPC like this if you go in any of the GTA hoods. Promise you. You know what I'm saying? I know this straight, like, this is crazy.
Man. Survived. Cook has accepted.
Okay, the victim survived.
Another teen being shot. The teen survived.
Okay, that's good.
Cook has accepted a plea deal that will drop a conspiracy charge, which carried a maximum penalty of life in prison. But counts of carjacking, attempted carjacking with a deadly weapon, and felony battery are still in play.
I just want to thank you. I think the kid needs one second chance so I can get out and finish school.
Man, fuck your school. You don't gotta worry about shit. No academic institutions. Don't worry about school. You can read books in jail. Don't worry about school. You get your GED in prison. Don't worry about passing school. Don't worry about school. The only thing you need to be worried about is them cell bars and them cell showers. That's all you need to be worried about. Don't worry about school.
I
can't
put my mama proud. Because I'm gonna be her first child to bring home.
Okay, y'all gonna say it's fucked up. It's okay, it's fine. I'm not gonna hold you. After what she did, I'll take it. That's pretty tough, but you literally ruined the chance of you being the first in your family to get a high school diploma because your dumb ass wanna go do some dumb. Talking about something, I'm gonna be the first. You should have thought about that before you did what you did, bro. Now nobody in your high school, in your family got a high school diploma. That's tough. You're supposed to be the first one and you fumbled terribly. And I'm supposed to feel bad? No.
And I just want to make my own crowd. That's it.
How'd that work?
Cook now prepares to hear her sentence. As her loved ones look on.
Ms. Cook here before the court for
free life. I don't know if they want to do her that dusty. Maybe. I don't know. Let's see.
Sentencing. A couple of things going in your favor. One, you didn't hold a firearm during these episodes. The second is that the victim luckily survived. That being said, this was intentional. It was an orchestrated ambush, and you are a main part of that. And for that, I'm going to go ahead and adjudicate you guilty of all three charges, sentence you to 20 years in state prison.
Mom crying. I do feel bad for the mom. Hey, 20 years not that bad. Ooh, that's coming from a who never been in prison. But hey, you did the crime, gotta do the time. 20 years not that bad. They dropped the charge off of you. You know what I'm saying? She take that 20 years to the chin. Get your GED in there, read some books, come out there a scholar. You're good.
Concurrent as to the first two counts.
The crying you hear is coming from Cook's mother. The sentence much more severe than they expected.
Charges.
Could have been worse.
All fines and costs.
I was talking about life. I forgot bro didn't actually like get packed up. So like.
It turns out that Cook and her mother's reactions were so intense because they believed the plea deal meant no prison time.
In what world was the plea deal going to mean no prison time, bro? With all them charges? You thought you was about to take the plea deal and you was about to get like house arrest or something like that? No, I don't think. It almost resulted in somebody's death. I don't think that's you was about to get off that crazy. The attempted murder, if you take a plea deal on attempted murder, can you get no time? That would be crazy. I'm not going to lie. There's probably a lot of cases out there where that's the case, but not you.
Judge Foxman allows her to enter a new plea deal, citing miscommunication between Cook and the assistant public defender. As a result of that new deal, Cook's sentence is reduced to 11 years in prison.
Wow.
We now head to the Nesbitt Courthouse in Anchorage, Alaska.
Alaska? Y'all got smoke in Alaska? I thought y'all just ice fist, ice skate, and like some old shit. But shout out to Alaska.
If you want to arrest me and drag me off, that's the only way I'm leaving.
David Haig came to court looking for justice. But instead, the judge ordered a new hearing to be held at a later date. And he's not having it.
If this court didn't do right the first time, it sure can't now. That they had screwed me out of a plea deal, that the state had falsified evidence, and now they're lying about everything to cover it all up. And that's just the beginning of it.
That's right.
The game pilot and tour guide is seeking to clear his name in a decades-old conviction, accusing him of killing wolves illegally while working with the state.
Oh, yeah, this is some Alaska. Only in Alaska is the motherfucker going to be killing wolves, bro. Yeah. Oh, yeah, this is an Alaska crime, bro. You never hear this anywhere.
Decades-old conviction.
Why was he out there slaying wolves, though? Like, would he need a new pelt? Like, what was he out there slaying wolves for? This is not Elden Ring.
And they used it at trial knowing it was false. That is another felony. And I'm putting my foot down.
He just caused a whole seismic earthquake across the whole state of Alaska. That's tough. A glacier just broke somewhere.
Because somebody has to.
I'm sorry, I have other...
So,
well, crap.
Well, you're gonna...
This one's more important. No more hearings here.
All right. No, no.
Sorry, Mr. Hank. Sorry, so sorry that our court system is so corrupt that they would do this to you.
Haig is charged with disorderly conduct for violating an order to leave a courtroom. Haig is charged with disorderly conduct for violating a...
Bro's just trying to go back home, chat. This is like minding my own business at top tier speed. Like, he just minding...
In order to leave a courtroom.
That's definitely his wife behind the camera has to be.
You.
His wife needs to get...
Haig's attempt to clear his name continues.
Oh, I mean, hey, he was hunting wolves. I don't know what he was doing, but bro is not happy about that, Chad. That's kind of tough. We're actually not done with the courtroom. We're getting right next to the next video. Top 4 courtroom insults. Now, as a motherfucker who gets insulted a lot and insults back, I feel like this would be good. So going right into the next one, since we're on the whole topic of courts right now.
We go to Wichita.
If I don't hear somebody call somebody a bitch ass nigga, it's not really about to cut it.
Kansas for the sentencing of Michael Gaines.
Damn.
He's been convicted of battery against a law enforcement.
Yes, Michael Gaines got a nugget, dog.
An officer. Gaines appears before Judge Rebecca Pilshaw, who speaks to the defendant about his actions.
All the evidence shows that you deliberately...
Yeah, okay.
The words were that you deliberately were hawking up...
I didn't hawk up no saliva, okay? That's...
Yo, some of y'all don't be trying to get on the judge's good side. Like, if I'm convicted of some shit, bro, I'm going to try to be on my best behavior. Because, like, you acting like this, a judge definitely going to give you the worst possible sentence. Why would I give somebody a good sentence and call me a... bro, like...
And you're going to believe those lies. That's what I'm talking about. I didn't hock up no saliva. You're going to believe a lie because they're wearing uniform.
The judge attempts to bring some order to the proceedings.
Look at me.
It's like evil. You ain't got to scream at me.
I mean.
You're going to raise your voice at me?
I mean, to be fair, like, you're like.
Gaines doesn't appear to be backing down from the judge. But it's nothing compared to what he has in store for Assistant DA Kevin O'Connor.
You raise your voice to me, I raise my voice to you. You just in a row.
I appreciate Mr. Gaines making my point for
you. You punk.
Very well received.
Yeah, yo, Kevin, I would have just shut the fuck up. My man not playing.
Maggot motherfucker.
And I don't...
He said it with the M, you know what I'm saying? So Twitch, relax.
I don't think I have to take insults from...
I know. You. Use a...
Oh, wow.
He's a tough guy now. But I think
you'll be a after I get sentenced.
I think Mr. Gaines is forfeited.
Yo, you. Yo, bro, don't give a. He like, hey, whatever I get is what I get. Yo, you know Kevin O'Connor feeling that dope, bro. He said you was a bitch and you gonna be a bitch after I get sentenced. That's tough. He said I could be in jail. You still gonna be a bitch. That's tough. I'm talking though, Michael. Oh, that's tough. Why has nobody removed him yet? Like, this is crazy.
I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go. You punk.
I'm talking.
You.
Take out of the courtroom. Dude.
Judge Pilshaw steps in, has Gaines removed. But before heading back to his cell, Gaines manages to get off a few more insults.
He's a maggot.
You're a tough guy.
He's a maggot, punk. You should have died when you was a baby.
Oh my God. Oh my God, bro.
Anytime, Mr. Gaines.
Shut up, punk. You're a maggot. You should have died when you was a baby. Still born. crazy.
The judge decides to go beyond okay, the 10 years and sentences Gaines to 13 years in a state.
Bro, lucky all he got is 13 years. Bro was talking his shit. Bro definitely made both of them cry when he got home, chat. Both of them was deaf crying when he got home, and that is tough.
Prison. Now to Durham, North Carolina, where Judge James Hill is presiding over a child custody case. For three long days, divorced parents Rashauna and Colin Morrison have been going at it, quite personally.
Oh yeah, there's about to be some toxic. Yeah, this is what we want to see right here, the toxicity.
I'm angry that his dad lives in Durham, can go on vacations with friends, take mistresses out to eat, take her on vacation, and can't seem to see his son.
The child's mother, Rashauna, claims her ex-husband abandoned their three-year-old son and failed to pay child support.
You can do a mod.
He argues she withheld his son from him and is seeking permanent custody. And the judge? Well, he isn't happy with either of them.
I could care less about it, couldn't he? I could. The two of you are not important.
And he's about to let them know it.
But two parents, and I'm going to choose my words very carefully here. Two parents can come in and act like such idiots. Y'all the one that crawled into bed and had sex and made that baby. He has to be born. But he was. What's important is and you don't need to see two adults acting like idiots.
Talk.
Did I say the word idiots?
He did. Three times.
Talk.
Afterward, Judge Hill turns his attention towards Rashauna.
I have no doubt that you have withheld that little woman. Don't you be looking at me.
I have not withheld.
You say one more word, you will get. You say one more word, you're going to go to the dirt guy in bed breakfast today. You say one more word.
See, I ain't gonna hold you. Just put his foot down, too. I ain't gonna hold. Look at this. Look at this heavy ass. Laughing, you know what I'm saying? He gonna get on you next, maybe. I don't know.
All right, that devil, she's got 24 hours of defend the court. We'll run her back as soon as we get done. All right, we got 48 hours. You were saying he's got 48 hours back then.
Rashauna eventually quiets down, and finally, after three heated days in the courtroom, the judge delivers his decision.
Both parents are fit and proper persons, have custody of the minor child. I mean, joint custody.
Just
say,
man, I can't do this. This is a disgrace. What you guys are doing, you need to let your son for 9 months. You don't take care of him. You're a drunk. You have a mistress. You have a mom who doesn't do anything for him.
I mean, to be fair, like, you kind of are contradicting yourself. You're acting like a fucking thug right now, you know what I'm saying? Bro's sitting here chilling, like, he's laughing. I know he's having the biggest internal, like, inner, like, laugh monologue right now, but, like, you's, like, acting a little thuggish, don't you think? It's crazy.
As officers try to restrain her, Morrison's brother, Sherrod Smith, comes forward from the back of the courtroom. At first, he tries to help by calming down his sister. Meanwhile, the judge makes a quick exit.
Just had to dip out.
As one deputy fights to gain control of Morrison, another puts her brother in handcuffs.
Why are you arresting bro for?
And here come even more officers to shut things down.
God, how many y'all need for this one? See, She-Hulk? Like, no.
As Morrison and Smith are taken away, a third person is also restrained in the back of the courtroom.
Who is that?
Their mother.
You should have videoed it. It's okay. You should have videoed it.
They were at 13 months. I underscore.
Mother hit with 48 hours in jail for resisting a public officer.
I'm late as
Morrison receives 30 days. Damn. Morrison and her husband now have a joint custody agreement.
Damn.
Judge James Hill received a public reprimand.
Pray for that child, bro. That child is under the worst conditions ever, bro. Those are the parents. Child is under, like, really, really terrible conditions. I ain't going to count. Pray for the child. That, above all, that's pray for the child, man.
And by the North Carolina Supreme Court for improperly exercising his contempt powers, failing to maintain.
I'm not hold you. He was being a little wild. By the way, why did the other, the bums who was trying to help get arrested? I don't know, but hey.
And decorum and making inappropriate comments. We head down to Daytona Beach, Florida.
Daniel, we'll see.
Where a call comes in to the Volusia County Sheriff's Office.
Communications, Warhurst.
Yeah, I want to report a crime that's about to happen.
What do you mean a crime that's
about to happen?
To happen.
Yeah, there's about to be a crime that's going to happen if my kids don't come back to me, you stupid.
Wait. Yo. Yo, I could never be a 911 operator, bro. I could never be a 911. Imagine somebody call you, bro, 911, what's your emergency? Oh, yeah. This might be a crime that's about to happen. You want to report a crime or nah? A crime is about to happen. A crime is about to happen. What do you mean by that? My kids don't come back to you, stupid. Yeah, I'm talking to you, you 911 operator. You probably look dusty as you probably stink. Your family probably don't love you. You's a, like, bro, I'm not going to care. I couldn't be no 911 operator, bro. I'm not going
to
lie.
My kids don't come back to me, you stupid. Because you're stupid. Judges don't want to bring people to courtrooms. I got a gun pointed at your building.
Like, bro, why you say me for? See, this is just like, remember I told you on customer service, they be hating on the cashiers and we don't even make the food? Bro, you blaming her? She's not even a part of the court system. Like, this is some regular lady at the 911 job.
Sir, what is going on?
Who the f*** you calling, sir, you stupid
please. Yo, this must, yo, whatever the wife did, bro, it must have been something that had some crazy character development, because this nigga just don't care. Like, this nigga talking crazy, chat. You having a bad day, bro? This is more than a bad day. That nigga's moving so crazy, bro.
Where's your judge warrant at? You gonna bring that out in handcuffs, and I'm gonna execute that son of a right in the street. I'm letting you know I'm gonna shoot this. You gonna with my kids.
Where are you at, sir?
I just told you I'm outside of her building waiting for her to get there in the morning. I'm gonna pop a cap in that.
Yo, yeah, this is insane. I ain't gonna hold you. It just goes to show how the property of man, because it should never be this area.
You stupid.
Hey! He just called her an N-word. Have we seen this, or do all like criminals just say the N-word, bro?
No, I doubt this is all being done unconstitutionally,
unrightfully.
Do you
want to be
in the room or not?
Do you
want
to? I prefer not to. Hey, you want something on me? Sir, no. Personally, I don't think I would want to. Yeah. This is so like, yeah.
Well, you got a mouth for it.
Yo, hey, yo, what the f***? Oh, yeah, he feeling a little freaked out. I know, like, there's something wrong with him, bro.
I'm not standing.
McCarty's removed again. This time he's placed in a back room one-way mirror.
Count one, I'm going to adjudicate him guilty. Sentence him to 15 years in Florida State Prison. As to count two, I'm going to adjudicate him guilty. Sentence him to 5 years in state prison to run consecutive to count one.
Well, now he's an idiot. If he loved his kids that much, he should have shut the f*** up and just did the whole legal process and been nice to the judge so he can see his kids faster. Now he never seen his kids. Well, probably not never, but now he guaranteed 5 years not seeing his kids. So, I mean, that was smart. I guess you ain't love your kids that much. Like, I guess that was smart.
So a total of 20 years.
McCarty's currently serving his sentence in a Florida state prison.
It's tough. Now you can't see your kids for 5 years. It's tough.
This is Jack Garrett, former chemist for Monsanto, St. Louis-based industrial chemical company, being sued by more than 1,700 people in Harris County, Texas. The neighbors are claiming they suffered severe health problems as a result of living near a toxic waste dump site once used by the company to discard hazardous materials. Garrett's here today for a deposition.
When you were at Monsanto, what was your title?
At Monsanto, what do you mean?
In Texas City.
Research chemist.
And this audio is crazy.
So far, so good.
Why put question marks? That's his name, Hugh Jazz. Why y'all?
But that's about to change.
Was that your title during your entire stay at Texas
that's
City?
Texas City, yes.
Don't talk over each other.
Interrupting is attorney Edward Karsterfan, who doesn't represent Garrett, but represents Monsanto, the company.
After you left Texas City...
Wait a minute, let me ask a question here.
Yeah.
Do you represent this guy or not?
Who are you?
My name's Tucker, and I represent Ayrshire, and I just want to know if you represent the guy or not. If you don't represent him, you don't have any right to be making any objection. If you do represent him, tell us so.
Karsterfan heard Tucker's suggestion and offers a suggestion of his own.
Why don't you keep your mouth shut?
And
I'll do what I want. No, you're
not. Yo, this is a court.
I ain't gonna hold you. Yo, this had a whole short circuit right there. He don't know what's going on, bro. He thinking about like Forrest Gump or something. I ain't gonna cap to you.
You won't?
Oh, wait.
Do what I want. No, you're not.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am.
That's bull.
Whatever objections I want to make, and I'll make them as loud as I want to make them. You just shut your mouth and we'll keep the record straight.
Terrible attorney. I know he's not his attorney, he's a company's attorney, but he's a terrible attorney. This is bad. This is bad representations. This is bad job titles.
Don't tell me to shut my mouth, boy.
Boy! Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa. Chill with that boy word, bro. Chill with that boy word. Y'all know how we feel about those. Chill with that boy word. That's not P. Come on, bro.
Shut your mouth and we'll keep the record straight.
Don't tell me to shut my mouth, boy. You may be big, but you won't see how bad you are. Come on.
And I wouldn't try that, Ed.
Are you threatening to fight?
Hold on just a second.
No, I want to know who's signed
my
servant
role.
We're going to be outnumbered, Ed.
Now, I'm going to tell you something else. You don't run this deposition. You understand?
Neither do you, Joe.
You watch and see who does. Big boy.
I'm telling you, Joe.
Big boy is crazy. Yeah, I mean, personally, I wouldn't let him talk to me like that personally, so I would just personally get up and smack the him in front of everybody. But that's just me personally.
Oh, you ain't telling me a thing. No, but don't be telling another lawyer to shut up.
Don't be telling
that ain't your job, fat boy.
Mr. Get back.
Don't be that ain't your job, fat boy.
Mr. Get back.
This deposition with lawyers making big bucks by the hour has officially devolved into an exchange of childish insults.
I said before, you have an incipient bad
What do you want to do
you?
About it?
Well, I'd like to knock you on your
come try it. Come over here and try it, you.
Bro, this attorney trying to save bro so bad.
Dumb son of a
wait just a second.
He's gonna eat him, Jack. He's gonna eat him. He's gonna do Majin Buu techniques.
Come try it. Come over here and try it, you.
Wait a
dumb son of a
wait just a second.
Come over here.
Hold it.
Hey, wait a minute. Hold on.
He's not gonna do none. He's not gonna do none. He's not gonna do none.
Oh, no way.
Get
thankfully, the two men never came to blows. But after the insults stopped flying, it was Jamal who ultimately landed the knockout punch. Monsanto Company.
Man, f*** that. We wanted to see motherfuckers throw hands, chat.
He settled the lawsuit and agreed to pay out $39 million.
That's tough. Yeah, that was a good video. Plug, I'm touching that. Do not touch those. Do not touch those. I need those. I need those. Yeah, man. It gets serious in the court, bro. It gets serious. You feel me? I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna have jury duty one of these days. And we know what I'm saying. We're gonna do stream in the... I'm kidding, of course. You feel me? I'm pretty sure you can. Well, no, you definitely can't do that. But... hey, if you're watching this on YouTube, Twitch Blue Rod, in the description. Come down to the stream. Come down to the stream. Don't miss it. You know what I'm saying? It's lit over here. You feel me? But, I BG. Alright.
Hurley beats back like I'm double heavy. Hold up, triple deuces. Hurley beats up, we got all the juices. Hold up, speak to heaven. Eat that by my mama, demon made it. Me body chill, at least I want by. No, 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 no.